HX, Dolby DTS. What are the differences in sound? What should I look for when I'm out shopping for a DVD player?
Well,
it's confusing.
It's ridiculous, actually. It's completely out of control. So DVDs, right? You think of a DVD. What is it? A DVD? It's a video you pick up from Blockbuster or your local video store, whatever it might be. It's two basic. Well, everything we're talking about here, all those letters, that alphabet soup, that's all talking about the audio that comes off the CD to play through your house.
Correct.
Correct. Now, the funny thing is you may have five amplifiers in your house. You may have what they call 5.1 speakers, right? That's the surround thing. You get a center channel, left channel front, right channel front, a subwoofer, and two channels in the back. That's
right.
Your basic five point one
speakers, one subwoofer, hence the name 5.1. Now, there's also things like 7.1. You're not going to see that as commonly.
That's
out there.
About every 6 weeks, somebody comes up with an idea to add a couple more speakers to give you more surround sound.
Mm-hmm.
You've probably been if you've been in a really good, maybe even a THX certified theater. We're going to explain that later on. You might feel, well, they've got like, you see where they have speakers like 18 down the wall.
Yeah, the movie's happening all around you.
Exactly. So over time, they're going to keep adding speakers and strange encoding systems to try to make that surround sound more realistic. For now, though, the big ones are Dolby Digital. It's classic, made by Dolby, who seems to do
Dolby.
Everything audio. To no.
No?
That's the artist.
The same guy.
Thomas Dolby?
Isn't it?
No. We'll explain that later. He blinded you with science back in the
80s. I thought it was the same guy.
No.
I was positive it's the same guy.
No, the audio Dolby came long before Thomas did.
I'm going to Google.
You Google away. So what it does, right, is it's an encoding system that compresses all this information for these different channels of audio. So it's, you know, it's in the front, it's in the back, it's in the rear, it's in the left and the right. Dolby Digital is one of the primary ones. DTS Digital is a competitor that came up recently. What the thing is, though, to get those to play, you actually have to have a couple things in there. One, you've got to have a DVD player that can either read is Dolby Digital or DTS ready. Two, you've got to have a decoder. So the audio, the digital signal goes from the back of your DVD player, it goes into a decoder. What's a decoder? It might be built into a receiver. But what it does is it splits that audio, that digital audio signal from the DVD player into all the different channels. On top of that, you're going to need five amplifiers, and you're going to need all those speakers to surround your house. You getting all this so far? Or are you still bitter about the Thomas Dolby thing?
I still say I'm right.
Dream on.
Sorry.
So, THX, that's another one that's bandied about in home theater. You think it's another encoding surround technology?
No, this is just a certification. This is something that Lucas invented back in 83 when Return of the Jedi came out. That was the first THX certified film. And all this is a set, it's like a standard. It's like if you could put the THX seal on it, it meets certain expectations.
A certain amount of wattage, speaker placement, the quality of the audio replica. Basically, he got ticked off that he was doing all these work to make these beautiful soundtracks, and a lot of theaters out there, big theaters, to kind of pay $42 to go to see a feature movie these days, had horrible sound systems. Getting THX certification was designed to say, hey, they're doing the good stuff so you can really hear the movie the way the director wanted to. One last thing, DVD audio. Just what we need. Just what we've got. We've got CD audio. We've got MP3. DVD audio, well, you know what? It might be a surround sound. It might be encoding it in a five-channel surround system. It's just another way to put music on a disc.
Right.
This time,
you're not going to be able to tell the difference between CD audio and DVD audio.
Well, in most cases, they actually do multiple surrounds.
Okay.
So they might actually immerse you in the crowd, which is like, so if you're listening to a live concert, you might hear the guy chewing gum to you next to the right, and that guy who's getting in the fight in the back over by the beer line. Makes it that much more realistic.
Just remember, for any of this stuff to work in your home theater, you're going to need a receiver that accepts this. All right, you're going to need the right kind of disc. You're going to need the speakers and the receiver.
Decoder.
Right.
Decoder might
work.
Be built
but you
the
don't
receiver.
Need, I mean, you could still have a DVD player and just attach it to your TV. You're just going to have stereo sound instead of all this.
Or you can attach it to your stereo and have stereo surround that
so
way.
So there you have it. Hey, go to thescreensavers.com where we'll go, we got 5.1 channels of detail on all this stuff.
And a shout out to Roman
from every direction
for an excellent article.
And now Eric joins us on the phone from Plymouth Meeting, Pennsylvania. Have all the callers been from Pennsylvania?
About 90% of them.
Yeah. Hey, what's up?
Hi.
Hey,
I'm wondering, how can I figure out if my CPU's burnt out?
Uh-oh. You know, as this guy here, because...
Funny you should ask, Eric.
Now, when you say burning out, you mean you've overclocked it.
Yeah.
Right? And you probably pushed the envelope a little too much, didn't you, Eric?
Well, see, I'm building one,
and
I think it might be burnt.
Are you getting any kind of postcode? Are you seeing any graphics on your monitor when you try to boot the system?
Seeing
no.
Seeing any smoke?
No.
Does it smell funny?
No.
Okay, these are all good signs. Have you ever tried to boot the system? Did you be, what, let me take a step back. What kind of processor is it?
It's one of the XP1900s.
So it's an Athlon, AMD Athlon. So did you ever try to start that without a heat sink?
I turned it on once, and I noticed that the heat sink wasn't plugged in, so I shut it off, but I don't know if I did it in enough time.
Was the heat sink actually clipped onto it?
Yeah.
Okay, so you probably are okay there if it was on. When you say short time, are we talking 30 seconds or like 20 minutes?
No, like 10, 15 seconds.
Yeah, I don't think it's an outside shot. I got a question for you. So this is, you just built the system, right?
Yeah.
Are these all brand new components?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. One of the things you're going to have to do is you're going to make sure your memory is seated properly. You're going to make sure your graphics card is seated properly. I'm a little nervous because you're not getting what they call a postcode. Do you know that you have a good power supply getting plugged into this?
Yeah. See, when I first turned it on, I did get output, but then I shut it off, and all of a sudden I wasn't getting anything.
Okay. What I'm going to recommend you do is two things. Is one, there's usually a jumper on the motherboard that'll reset all the basic BIOS settings. I want you to look for that jumper and reset that. Before you reset that, though, there's going to be in the manual for the motherboard to tell you where that is.
Mm-hmm.
Before you do that, I want you to go through really carefully. I want you to check all your cables, and I want you to pull out and reseat all the components, the cards, everything except for the processor. That one, you're going to look at it. You're going to make sure you double-check to make sure you put your goop on it, make sure it's nice and seated and clipped down there and plugged in. Everything else, I want you to physically pull the memory out and put it back in and make sure everything's clipped in and pressed in tight and give that a shot. Hopefully, one of those things will fix that for you. That's a tough one. Debugging the system when you first start, especially if you're not getting a postcode.
Yeah.
And make sure you plug the speaker in, because you want to hear if you get that postcode. That's a huge, huge help. The power on self-test, it'll beep at you to try to tell you what's wrong.
Hey, Eric, thanks a lot for the call. It was a really good question. Man, I hope you didn't
that would be a major bummer.
You know, if you got an XP1900, you know, you don't really need to overclock something like that. That's like the fastest processor, one of the fastest processors. That they make, AMD. So probably don't need overclock.
Be careful.
Yeah, be careful. It's an expensive thing. Hey, Kat, you have the preliminary results of the web poll.
Why, yes, I do. Her question, which would you rather do, pay for Napster? 18% of you said pick that, or get an ultrasonic vasectomy. 82% pick that. Goodness, you've still got 24 hours to vote, so go vote already. Now, the instant message quote of the day. Send us your instant messages and use the name TSS Thought. Robert says, I haven't lost my mind. I backed it up on the network, but the server's down.